You have to keep the kids entertained, but that doesn't mean you have to forego learning and productivity. So here with some of her favorite ideas is Tonya Dalton, productivity expert and founder of Inkwell Press Productivity Company. That's a mouthful there. Good morning.
It is. I'm getting you on your toes this morning.
Yeah. You know what? As a parent, I'm so glad you're here because we always need some ideas, you know, to help keep these kids active during the summer and keep their minds going.
I think that's so true. And one of the things that we forget is that we have to teach our kids to be productive.
Right.
It's not something that happens naturally. So I think it's really important for us to instill some productivity tips and ideas into our kids as they're growing up.
So what's the first thing we can do at home?
Yeah, so I think one of the big things you can do is really allow your kids some autonomy, letting them be independent. And so one of my favorite ways to do this is the boredom box.
Okay.
So this is something I came up with myself back when I was starting my first company and my kids were really, really little. My kids are really, really big now. They're 6'2". But when they were really little and I needed to get work done, I had this idea for the boredom box. And what I do is, and you can use any box that you want. You can use an Amazon box, just something you have on hand. This is not something to stress
you out. Sounds easy, yeah.
Yeah. And then basically, you fill it with different activities the kids can do themselves. The first activity, grab some crafts and let them decorate the box.
Oh, yeah, that will definitely keep them busy. They get really into that, so that's good. Okay.
Yes. Other ideas, games they can play, puzzles, all kinds of activities to keep them entertained by themselves. Because really, learning to entertain themselves is a key part to being productive, right?
And we need some me time.
Yes, we do.
Just a little bit.
The hardest part of summer is what am I going to do next with our kids, right?
Right.
So this really does allow them a little bit of excitement because it's something fresh and exciting and new when you pull it out, but it also allows them to learn how to be productive themselves.
Right. So is there like a daily routine also that they can do?
Yes, I definitely advocate having a daily routine for your kids. Okay. So one of the things you can do is work with your kids, let them have a say on what they want to have happen in the morning. You know, obviously there's brushing your teeth and making your bed and things like that, but let them have some ideas too of what they want to have happen in the morning. And then a great idea is to write it out on a chart and let them check it off themselves. Again, entertaining themselves, making them be productive while you can still get your work done.
Yes. All right. And talk about this quiz of the day that you were mentioning earlier.
Yeah. So one of the things you could do also that I love to do with my kids is I like to post a quiz of the day, either a quiz of the day or a drawing of the day or some sort of activity that then we talk about at the end of the day. So I'll post it usually at the bottom of the stairs because they come down the stairs in the morning. And then I post it. And during the day, they either work on trying to figure out the answer to the puzzle or doing the drawing.
Yeah.
And then we talk about it at dinner. Or if we're doing a drawing, we'll show it to each other.
Good. Keeps their minds active.
Yeah, and it's really easy to find those resources. I mean, there's those doodle books you can find. Rip out a page, post it up
on
the wall.
Yeah, speaking of books, you have one coming out about productivity, right?
I do. I do. Focus on productivity for women. So The Joy of Missing Out is coming out this October. I'm really excited about it. It's one of the first productivity books written for women by a woman.
So awesome.
I know. It really is very exciting because we do live very different lives, right?
That's so true.
Yep. We're the CEO of the office and we're the CEO of the home.
Hit it on the nail there.
Thank you so much
for coming in this morning. We appreciate you.
Absolutely.
Well, it is 8:20 and still to come. Here's one way to get around traffic law.